too that much?
No.
Okay, so welcome, and my name is Daniel Kofi Safo AC, but you can call me Kofi Safo. Basically at home, that's what I'm called. And I am glad to be here with this wonderful group, Africans for the Africans, and it's been a wonderful journey so far. Right now you could see we're driving on the countryside, heading to Kumasi, and a famous name for Kumasi is the Land of Gold, or the Garden City. And Kumasi has a rich history and culture that anybody, anywhere should come and take a look at. For me, working in this business or industry has been a great thing for me. It's been a very life-changing and very educational thing for me. I have learned so much from the people I have met all over the world. I always say this, if I'm not able to go travel outside, I always get the world coming to me and sharing my part of the world and hearing from others and learning from them also gives me or exposes me to the other parts of the world. But I would say you need to be in Ghana. It's some place you have to visit, though you don't mean. So Ghana is wonderful, and you know, it's the first sub-Saharan African country to gain independence in Africa. And you will know that Ghana has a rich history from where it has started from. When it comes to democracy, we are considered as one of the beacon in West Africa and even in Africa. Ghana has so many cultures, so many variety of people. The reason I love my country is Ghana is very diverse, but one thing about it, we are a very peaceful, loving country. One of the hospitable people in the world. We always would welcome you with our famous thing that we say is Akwaba. And Akwaba means welcome. And we'll say Madamfo. Madamfo means friend. Or you could hear the famous word Chale, which I'm sure some of our friends here already heard. Chale means friend. And so we are very friendly people. I come from the eastern side of Ghana. It's called the eastern region, a people called the Kwewu. We actually live in the mountain side. While we are driving, it will be very soon, will be close by. The Kwewus have good culture. They are part of the Akan group. The Akans in Ghana are made of different ethnic groups. We speak a language called the Chi language. And they are the majority of the ethnic groups we have in Ghana. Everywhere you go, at least you have, out of 10, you have about 6 or 8 people who speak the Akan language, which means we are in the majority side. But one of the thing is, we have so many things that we want to share with our families and friends who always come here. Our food. You should try Ghanaian food. If you've not tried jollof rice in Ghana, then you're missing something. So you need to try it. You need to try our fufu. It's cassava and plantain pounded together, and it goes with soup, either pepper soup, or if you've not tried the goat meat soup before, you should try it. You need to try the chicken soup as well. We have variety. You have wache. Wache is actually beans and rice cooked together. It's the best. And you know, one thing you don't know, or you should know, is that Ghana produces the best cocoa in the world. We are number one in terms of quality, and then we are the second largest producer of cocoa in the world. We used to be the first, but when it comes to quality, we are number one. Where we're driving is a cocoa major production area, and you can see cocoa farms all around. Cocoa is harvested in 2 seasons, major seasons. We have the major season where it's harvested is actually in October, and we have another one that's harvested around March, April. These are when our farmers go into work and work around. So you should come to Ghana, and then when you come, there's more to see, more to hear, and then more to experience. Our love for people is overwhelming. Our love for people is warm. Our love for people is what would keep you coming and coming again. So don't miss this opportunity to be here. Don't miss this opportunity to travel with the many groups that are coming to Ghana. And I can tell you, next year is going to be amazing, because next year actually marks 400 years that the first enslaved ship arrived in Americas. And we are celebrating this year not as slaves bounded by chains, we're celebrating as people, African people, proud to be free, to let the world know that we are free people. We can make us strong, we can make our nation strong, we can make the continent strong, and we can actually make the world strong. So come and don't miss this opportunity. Thank you and Medasi.